Good evening, everyone. My name is Jenny Lynn, along with Elmer and our mixed ministry music here at St. Augustine. And we would like to welcome everyone to this special daily mass that will be presided by Bishop Mylo. We have almost about 30 or more priests here today who are the leaders of the National Association of Filipino Priests in the U.S.A. So we ask y'all to please rise and join us in our entrance song, song number 569. Join in the dance, song number 569.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends in the Lord, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us first call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Enable us, we pray, Almighty God, to proclaim the power of the risen Lord, that we who have received the pledge of His gift may come to possess all He gives when it is fully revealed through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. Thus Joseph, also named by the apostles Barnabas, which is translated son of encouragement, a Levite, a Cypriot by birth, sold a piece of property that he owned, then brought the money and put it at the feet of the apostles. The word of the Lord.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. There was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. He came to Jesus at night and said to him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these things that you are doing unless God is with him." Jesus answered and said to him, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless one is born from above, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said to him, how can a man once grown old be born again? Surely he cannot re-enter his mother's womb and be born again, can he? And Jesus answered, amen, amen, I say to you, unless one is born of water and spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. What is born is flesh, and what is born of spirit is spirit. Do not be amazed that I told you you must be born from above. The wind blows where it wills, and you can hear the sound it makes, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit. The Gospel of the Lord.
Brothers and sisters, good afternoon. I'm sure it feels strange to have a lot of priests in this parish, with the parishioners not just getting used to going again to the 5:30 p.m. Mass here. What a wonderful and blessed experience, not to have many priests concelebrate. In a weekday Mass. But given the announcement of Father Ray yesterday, as we all know, the National Association of Filipino Priests in the U.S.A. are here to actually plan for their upcoming gathering next year, 2025, which will be hosted here. No? 2026, no? Not 2025, no? Masyado yata ako na-excite, no? 2026, no? And I think the readings today specify many things, no, about the picture of what we have as having in this celebration. The first reading is the experience of the first Christian community, no? One could just imagine after the Lord resurrected and ascended to heaven, the disciples banded together, no? And this picture from Acts 4, which also has a reference in Acts 2, no, tell us of three things. First, unity, no? The unity of the disciples. They communed with each other. And how beautiful it is, no, for Filipino priests to be united, no, not only here, no, in California, here in the Bay Area, but of course in the whole North America. Secondly, encouragement, no, the disciples of the Lord in their coming together, in their communion, no, made sure that, you know, there would be disciples, no, who would also be attracted to their cause and to their way of life. And one of them is Barnabas, called Son of Encouragement. No? What an encouraging experience, no, to be together, to band together, to be united for a purpose. No? And finally, if you look at Acts 2 and Acts 4, what transpired in the experience of the first Christian community is that they had to survive and made sure that all what they had, everything was held in common. It was actually the living out of stewardship. You know? No one felt hungry. No one felt they were in need because everything was shared in common. So you see here, unity, encouragement, and stewardship. I think this is how we would characterize the past years, no, for our Filipino priests, no, living here in the U.S. and sharing themselves in ministry. when we celebrated the 500-year anniversary of Christianity in the Philippines, the tagline has been gifted to give. No? And one can just look at this blueprint, this grand plan of God. More than 500 years ago, the seeds of faith were planted in our land. The European missionaries went to us, and we were blessed. And because of that, we became the majority Catholic country in Asia, aside from East Timor. But because of our bigger population, we are tagged as this majority Catholic country in Asia. Look now, what has happened to the seeds of faith. Look what's happening in the West. Lesser vocations in their country, lesser priests, and we are now being sent on mission to this part of the world. No? This gives me goosebumps at times, though, when I think about it. Who would ever imagine that we would be the one exporting priests, exporting nuns? And do you know that even the Carmelite monasteries in different parts of the world are losing their vocations, and they're taking Carmelite nuns from the Philippines, no, to fill in their own monasteries. No? If you go to Rome, you will just be, you know, awestruck by the leadership of the many congregations. They are Filipino priests and Filipino nuns, no? Consecrated people. That is what it means to be gifted to give. Because of this whole experience of the first Christian community, we look at unity, we look at encouragement, we look at stewardship as so much alive. And isn't this enough motivation to prepare for 2026? We look at our gospel, and the personality at the forefront of the gospel, aside from Christ, is Nicodemus. We will hear of this dialogue between Jesus and Nicodemus. I'm sure you have sort of glanced or have watched already the series of The Chosen. No? If you have not, it's already in Netflix. No? And the character that immediately came out in that series, no, in the ministry of Christ, at first is Nicodemus from start to end. What will you see in this person of Nicodemus? You will see the unfolding, the development of a character from an undercover disciple to a follower of Christ. You look at the Gospel of John. The first part tells us of how Nicodemus, like in our Gospel today, was there with curiosity, with an open mind to the teaching of Jesus. He was a Pharisee. He was a revered leader of the Jews in terms of their religious group. But he had an open mind and heart to listen to Jesus, to be taught by Jesus. And that became the development of his discipleship. What is striking here is that in the end, and I'm sure you heard it when we celebrated, no, our Good Friday liturgy in the Gospel of John, in John 19, Nicodemus showed himself during the burial of Jesus. He was with Joseph of Arimathea, no longer hiding in the night. He was there and showed himself as a follower. He was no longer afraid to what his fellow Pharisees would say about him. Discipleship. I'd like to address now our Filipino priests. In a way, that character of Nicodemus can be likened to you. Think about how you have come here. how perhaps you have either migrated here or found your vocation here. This movement of your vocation to follow the Lord, to serve the Lord. Perhaps there are many questions. Can I be able to become a priest in a country like this? We know it's different in the Philippines. Far different even in the urban and rural dioceses. But then perhaps the Lord whispered to your heart, you have been wrestling, will I pursue ministry here for a long time? And later on, as things unfolded, you're here and serving your particular diocese. You're serving the church, not only ministering to Filipino-American Catholics, but different nationalities who are Catholic. And how you have blessed them because of your celebration of the Eucharist, you're preaching, you're ministering, you're going to their homes. How you have engaged because you have brought Christ to them. I'd like to end by looking at the word Nicodemus. Very interesting. The Greek word has its etymology. It's divided into Nike and Demos. Nike means victory. Demos means populace or common people. So if you look at the two words joined together, victory of and for the common people. You are Nicodemus to your community, dear brother. You have been the victory of Christ to them as you have served them. Continue inspiring them. We are not perfect, but continue to become a living example of Christ amidst your frailties, amidst this task and this whole process and wanting to be holy. And believe me, whether you will retire here or die here or go back to the Philippines, you have served your purpose well. And like in the parable of the talents, I can assure you, the Lord will tell you, my good servant, my great servant, my blessed servant priest, you have done well. Share in your master's joy. Amen. Amen.
We present to the Lord our petitions as a Christian community. Let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our
prayer. For our Holy Father and all bishops and priests, may Jesus continue to conform them evermore to his heart as they minister to the faithful. Let us pray to the Lord. For all nations, may the witness of committed Christians foster and increase respect for human life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who suffer with mental or physical illness, may the Holy Spirit outpour his healing and consolation upon them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For each of us gathered here, may the graces and merits of partaking in the Eucharist draw us deeper in union with our Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. for our beloved dead, especially Danilo Tamayo, Genoveva Julian Ico. May they feast with the angels and saints in the presence of God the Father. Let us pray to the Lord. We also pray for the healing of Ellen Paguntalan. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, we present to you these our needs. Respond to them according to your holy will through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
As we present our gifts to the altar, please join us in singing Psalm number 442. O God, you search me. Psalm number 442.
Pray now, my dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice for the praise of your holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oscar, our Bishop, his brother bishops, and all the clergy.
Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Aming kapanin sa araw. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Good afternoon. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Bilingual po tayo dito, English Tagalog, sabi nila. Ako po ay si Father Vic de la Cruz from the Diocese of Homotibido in Louisiana. And today I'm joined by my brothers from all over the United States, beginning our organizational meeting for the 5th National Assembly of the National Association of the Filipino Priests in the United States, which was founded in 2011 in Los Angeles, California. So after almost 15 years of going around the country, we're coming back to California to have our 5th National Assembly, and we are excited to come back to where we are started. Father Ray and the Filipino-American priests of Northern California are so gracious to welcome us back and to host us as we try to gather together as a fraternity of priests. Your presence here tonight and your support we love and we look forward to, because the Filipino-American priests of the United States love you, and we would like to continue serving you as ministers and servant leaders of our community. This year, we are celebrating the Year of the Eucharist. It's so important for us because this is where we receive the mandate from Christ in the Eucharistic celebration. So it's a very symbolic year for us to have the preparation during this year, which next year we enter the Jubilee year, the holy year that the Holy Father will declare, and then that will be followed by the National Assembly. Father Ray was so kind enough to allow us to launch this first public presentation of our National Assembly, and the word will get out, mga kapatid. We are looking forward for your help and your support to get the word out. The Filipino priests in the whole United States are coming to your place to celebrate. So watch out, brace yourself, it's gonna be fun. And as you all know, California, the western part of the United States, is one of the biggest gathering of Filipino immigrants in the United States. The first known historical place where the Asian presence in the United States happened, and so now it's going to be the host of the biggest national association. And we are so blessed today to have Bishop Mylo Vergara, the Bishop of Pasig in outside of Manila, and the Apostolic Administrator of San Pablo Laguna to give us this blessing as we begin. Because as you all know, priests, we share in the ministry of bishops. And so it's always wonderful to have a bishop to remind us that we are his closest collaborators, and without the head, we are nothing. Bishop Mylo, salamat pong marami. And tonight, we are also grateful that we have heard Father Ray that we are going to be fed quite well. And for those of us, for those who are not from California, you know, food for us is quite serious. We take that very seriously. So maraming salamat po at pagpalain kayo ng pong may kapal.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.